We know that Instagram Reels is getting a ton of traction on the platform right now, but it really means that we need to be taking advantage of this inside of our marketing plan for our businesses, and we really need to be using the tools that Instagram offers to us. So as you're creating your Reels, we know that once we get to the point of posting, you actually have the option of creating a cover image, and that can be a little hard for people, a little bit tricky, so let's talk about some best practices and things that I found that are working really well right now that not only make your grid look pretty and not only help to tell people what your video is going to be about, but really strongly classify them and almost create like a playlist effect inside of your Reels page on your Instagram account. Now, if you don't know how to make Reels, I have videos on that down below. You can check those out. Today, we're just talking about those cover images, but I got all the good resources for you below if you need them. So when it comes to cover images, these are those vertical images on your Instagram page. And you do have the ability to send your video over to your main feed, and I highly recommend you do. That's where you're gonna get a lot of your traction. Again, see the videos all about captions and using your hashtags and all the good stuff that's linked down below. But you wanna make sure you've got a really strong image. You're gonna send it over to your main feed, so it's gonna be in your grid, but because the cover images are vertical, they are the up and down images that go the length of your phone, you have to keep in mind only the square center part is going to your main feed. So if you're designing something really pretty that looks really good and vertical, it may not translate super well to your main feed. So you have to make sure you keep the majority or the important stuff inside of that square, that invisible square, on your post. So I'm actually going to be including a template, and you can kind of see where it's blocked off. So you keep the majority of your information there because that's what's going to be seen by most people in the future. Now, that does not mean you should only pay attention to that inside square. You do need to be paying attention to the entire vertical image, because when people click over to your Reels, or even if they're just seeing it, especially if they're like scrolling through on your stories or something, they are going to see that full thing there. So I found a little trick. Now, you could create an image that is the full length of that vertical image, and I started out doing that. But I had to make sure that the majority of what I was doing stayed in the center. And it can be really hard to take a nice looking photo that has enough room up at the top that you're not like cutting off someone's face on your main feed, and enough room at the bottom that you're not like having people floating. So if you're cutting things out, if you're just showing things, you don't want them just floating there. So you can create one long vertical image, and I did that for a while. And when I did that, I didn't put words on it. You can. If that fits with your feed, you can absolutely do it. But if it doesn't fit with your feed, you're gonna wanna avoid those words on there. So how do you then go about creating something that actually communicates what your video is going to be about? So I found a little trick that I started implementing earlier this week and has worked really, really well. So what I do is I actually take my template and I put a background on it. This is just a colorful background. And for my different projects, I have different colored backgrounds. So I keep them all relatively the same. So when people are going through, they can identify my series very easily inside of my Reels. So one series is going to have like a pinkish kind of background. One series is going to have like a marble background. One series is going to have bright colors. And they're all very, very different, and they're labeled. And that's where my trick comes in. So when I am creating these, I have the background there, and it's usually like a textured background, but I consider it like a solid, neutrally type background. And then in that center square, I actually put my photo or the image that I'm going to be sending out. That way, I don't have to crop anything weird, because again, when I take my photos of me for my social media, I am actually taking those so there's not a ton of headroom and not a ton of like space on the bottom. It's like pretty up close. So I want to make sure I'm not cutting anything off that's going to look weird on my main feed. So I'm able to just put my square image right there in the center. And if I'm a little worried about it, I'll make it slightly bigger. So that's a pro tip for you. If you're worried about it like cutting off and showing part of that border around it, you can make it a little bit bigger, because it's not going to matter when people see the full vertical, but it won't have that background in it. So you want to make it bigger than you think if you need to. So at that point, I put my photo there, and I don't put any words on there because on my grid, I don't really use words. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. It depends on your feed, your aesthetic, what you do. You do whatever you need to do to match your news feed. And then you are going to, above it, you're going to start classifying it, because people aren't going to see this on your main feed. So this is actually a great place to include words, include a title, talk about the series name. So if I'm putting something up for a series, I will include the title of the series, and then I can either choose to title the video, or I can just kind of leave it with the series name if I want people to just kind of watch through them. So that depends. If it's more of an educational thing, absolutely recommend having a title there so people know what they're going to click on and see. If it's more of an entertainment thing and you just kind of want to see them go through the series, they can just do that. You don't have to classify it too terribly much with extra words. So for me, I will put the series title usually down below, and I'll put the title up above. Whatever you decide, make sure you stick to it. You want the aesthetic to be somewhat similar over on your Reels page. So either put your title up at the top, or you're going to put your title down at the bottom, and then anything extra can go on either end of that. And you keep your image in the middle. This is going to give that very nice, clean, curated look to what you're creating. But when people go over to see the Reels, they can actually scroll through and almost treat it like a playlist. They can decide by the title that you've put on your cover image if it's going to be something that they want to watch, so that they don't have to scroll through a bunch of things. And this helps you because if they're looking for specific answers, or if they like one of your series but don't want all of your other content, they're not going to have to scroll through a bunch of them to get to the one that they want. If they have to scroll through and they keep finding things they don't like, they're going to stop watching. They don't need to go through all of your stuff because they can see very clearly that there's a good chunk of it that they're not going to like. So if you very easily give them the content that they want to see, they're going to watch the things that they want to see without running away from everything you have created. So as you do this, what I'm implementing and what I would encourage you to implement is to put a square image or a square-ish image in that center section of your template, and then have a nice background that stays true to the series that you are doing or stays true to your branding. So if you only do one thing and you're just giving tips and tricks, go for it. One background, that's fine. If you have several different series or different topics, or even if you're doing like 10 steps to this and each reel is a different step, classify all of those by having the same background. Make them look alike, make them look like part of a series, make them look like part of a playlist so that they can go and find them when they're looking for them, especially if they're not back to back to back when you were posting them. And this is a great way to classify what you have created, really form almost like a playlist on your Instagram Reels, and keep your aesthetic beautiful, clean, and curated to your branding the way that you want over on your main feed. Again, if you need more information on how to create those Reels, or how to extend the life of them, how to get more views on them, how to use your caption and your hashtags and all the good things, I have videos linked down below, because we really want to lean strongly into Reels right now, because that is where we're getting thousands and thousands and thousands of extra views, because Instagram is so strongly pushing their Reels. So I teach you everything you need to know about Reels and give you all the latest breaking news when it comes to Instagram or any of the social media platforms. So hit the subscribe and notification bell. I am bringing you breaking news as it happens to make sure you stay on top of your social media game so that you can create more profit inside of your business through your smart social media marketing. We're going to continue to talk about how you can be growing on Instagram, on TikTok, on Clubhouse, on YouTube, on Facebook, and on all the great social media platforms in the next couple of videos, so make sure you stick around, and if you've got a question, drop it down below, or if you have something you need to learn and you would like me to teach you, let me know. I am always happy to write down your topic ideas and make videos or answer them over in our community tab. And I would love to hear from you. Until next time, I hope you have a great day and stay inspired.